You're watching Minutee Maths. In this video we are going to explain the special case of zero factorial. For an introduction to factorials, check out the video linked above. Subscribe to Minutee Maths for weekly videos. You might wonder what it means to calculate the factorial of zero. In mathematics, the factorial of a non-negative integer, n, denoted by n factorial, is the product of all positive integers less than or equal to n. For example, 5 factorial is equal to 5, times 4, times 3, times 2, times 1, which is 120. Now, let's talk about zero factorial. Surprisingly, its value is equal to 1. But how can this be if we are not multiplying any numbers together? Let's have a look at this pattern of factorials. Notice that if we work in descending order, each value can be divided by the value of n. So, once we reach 1 factorial, if we are following this rule, then we divide this value by 1. 1 divided by 1 equals 1. Hence, if we are following this convention, then 0 factorial is equal to 1. This convention has been generally agreed by the mathematical community, as it works well with many equations and allows for consistent results. Let's have a look at an alternative way of demonstrating why 0 factorial equals 1. Here we have 3 numbers on a lock, and we want to see how many different ways there are of arranging them. We can see there are 6 different combinations. We can use 3 factorial to show this. Now let's look at 2 numbers. We have 2 different ways of arranging them. With 1 number there is only 1 way to arrange it. And finally, with 0 numbers, there is still only 1 way to arrange it. Thanks for watching, that's all for today, but be sure to check out next week's video explaining how we can use factorials to determine combinations and permutations.